So welcome to lecture 2 of theory of computation. In this lecture we will go through language, symbol, alphabet, strings or words, operation on string, operation on language. So when you hear the term language, what comes into your mind? Odia, Hindi, English, Tamil, Telugu, these languages come into your mind. So we use the languages for communication purpose. Similarly, there is another class of language that is called as formal language. So under formal languages, our programming language comes into the picture. So now you have studied so many programming languages. So in this subject, theory of computation, we will deal with the programming languages. So what exactly a language is? So a language is a language can be defined as a system which is suitable for expression of certain ideas, facts or concepts, which includes a set of symbols and rules to manipulate this. For example, English language. So this English language has a set of symbols A to Z and a set of rules. By using those rules, we will manipulate these symbols and we will use it for our communication. Similarly, formal languages like programming languages also used to express some certain ideas, facts and concepts, which also includes a set of symbols and a set of rules to manipulate this. So let us go through formal language. So before going to language, when I will tell you one thing, when you have started learning English, what you have started first? First, you have started learning the symbols of the language. So symbols is nothing but the alphabets A, B, C. So let us first know what exactly a symbol is. So the symbols are indivisible objects or entities that cannot be defined. So if I will ask you why it is called as A, can anybody define me? No, because this is a symbol which cannot be defined. Okay. If I will ask you why it is called as Z, can anybody define? No. So symbols are the indivisible objects. Indivisible object means you cannot divide the symbols. If you will divide a symbol, it will not have any meaning in that language. So the symbols are indivisible objects or entity that cannot be defined. So a symbol is any single object such as A, 0, 1, hash, dot, dot, dot. So usually characters from a typical keyboard are only used as symbols. So I hope all of you have understood what exactly a symbol is. Next, let us go through alphabet. So alphabet is a finite, non-empty set of symbols. So let us consider the English language. So in English language, there are 26 symbols. So what is the alphabet of English? So it consists of 26 symbols. So which is a finite as well as non-empty set of symbols. It's called as alphabet. So alphabet is usually a set of symbols. So the alphabet of a language is usually denoted by summation. So I repeat again, please don't write anything. I will tell you what you have to write. Okay. You just try to understand. If you are having any doubt, you can ask me at any point of time. When more than one alphabets are considered for discussion, then subscripts may be also used. So the alphabets are denoted by summation, or this we will call it as alphabet. So it can be also represented by a subscript, alphabet 1, alphabet 2, etc. So for example, alphabet 01, so it is the alphabet set for the binary language. Similarly, you can define a set of symbols as an alphabet. Okay, so similarly these are defined. Now let us go through what exactly a string or word is. So you see, while learning English language, first you have learned the alphabets of English language, that is A, B, C, D, dot, 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 Z. Then after you have learned the alphabets, then you have learned the words of English, A for apple, B for boy, C for cat. Similarly, what exactly a string is? A string is also called as a word. So a string or word over an alphabet is a finite sequence of concatenated symbols. So it is nothing but a concatenation of set of symbols. So for example, if we will consider the input alphabet over the binary language 0 and 1, then the words, some of the words may be 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. So what is it? This is a word. So it consists of a set of symbols. So a string or word over an alphabet is a finite sequence of symbols. So similarly, AAB, ABCB, B, CC are four strings over the alphabet ABC. So this is one of the important thing. It is not the case that a string over some alphabet should contain all the symbols from the alphabet. Here you can see, here the alphabet is ABC. So a string may contain all the symbols or may not contain all the symbols. For example, AAB is a string over the alpha input alphabet ABC. But here you see, in this string we do not have C. This is exactly similar to our in English alphabet. So in English alphabet we have A to Z symbols, A B C D dot 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 Z symbols. So if I will use a word RAM, R A M, so in that word I do not have all the alphabets of English. So here I hope all of you have understood this point. It is not the case that a string over some alphabet should contain all the symbols. So it may contain some symbols or it may not contain some symbols. Next, convention. So how we will represent the words and words or strings and the alphabets? So we will use small case letters towards the beginning. What the beginning means? A, B, C, small case, A, B, C of English to denote alphabets, to denote symbols of an alphabet. So symbols are usually denoted by the lower case letters beginning from the English alphabet A, B, C. Similarly, small case letters towards the end are used to denote the strings. Suppose we want to denote a string, so it's better we use the U, V, double X for representing the strings. So let us use a string W equal to 0, 0, 1. 1, 0, 0, 1. So here you see, here I have two words. One is 0, 0, 1, another one is 1, 1, 0. So this, here you see, 1, 1, 0, here the symbols are 1 and 0. Or what you can do, W equal to A, B, C, A. So here you see, A is used as a symbol, B is used as a symbol, C is used as a symbol, whereas W is used to represent a string or set of strings. So let me confirm you. So here we have to write actually W equal to A, B, C. So W is denoting a string. So actually we will not call this as a string, we will call it as a language. Similarly, this one also we will call it as a language, because language is a finite non-empty set of words, whereas W, a word, is a concatenation, finite non-empty concatenation of symbols. Next, operations on strings. So first one is length of string. So the number of symbols in the string W is called as length. So denoted by mod W. So for example, the length of 0111 is 1, 2, 3, 4. Similarly, the length of 11 is 2. Similarly, the length of B is 1. So here there is one interesting symbol that is called as epsilon. The length of epsilon is 0. So here you see this symbol, we will read it as epsilon. Okay, so now let us go through this point. It is convenient to introduce a notation epsilon for the empty string. Empty string means the string whose length is 0. So here the length of empty string epsilon is 0, that is mod of epsilon is 0. So I hope all of you have understood what is the length of a string. It is pretty simple. Next, concatenation. So let two words or two strings x equal to a1 a2 dot 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 an and y equal to b1 b2 dot 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 bm be two strings, then concatenation of xy is denoted by xy is the string. So what is xy will represent? A1 a2 dot 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 an followed by a copy of y, that is b1 b2 b3 dot 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 bm. So concatenation of x and y denoted by xy is the string that has a copy of x followed by a copy of y without any intervening space. So here there is no space. So if I will write one example, w equal to 011, x equal to 100. So if I want to concatenate wx, then it will be denoted by wx. So here First, it will keep a copy of W, that is 0, 1, 1. Then it will keep a copy of X, that is 1, 0, 0. So there should not be any space between W and X. So I hope all of you have understood what is concatenation. So note that for a string W, we can write W epsilon. Epsilon means what? Zero length string. It represents nothing. Okay. So W is equivalent to W epsilon, which is equivalent to epsilon W, which is equivalent to W. So it is also obvious that mod X means length of X. So if length of X is N, if length of Y is M, then the concatenation of XY, it is represented by XY, that is mod of XY equal to N plus M. So it is pretty simple here, you see, mod of W equal to 3, mod of X equal to 3, when we will take mod of WX, we will get 3 plus 3, that is 6. So similarly here you can also take y equal to, let's say, 0. So if I will write WY, so it will represent 0, 1, 1, W, then y means 0. So if I will find the length of WY, then I will get 3 plus 1, that is 4. I hope all of you have understood the concatenation. Next, let us go through another operation, that is called as prefix, suffix, and substring. So I hope all of you have came across these terms. So let us go through one thing. U is a prefix, a prefix of V, if V equal to UX, where U is for some string, sorry, where X is a string. So X is a string. So this string may also be epsilon. Epsilon is a what? Epsilon is a 0, 0 length string. So X may also be epsilon. So let us go through an example. Consider the string 0, 1, 1 over the binary alphabet. So what are the prefix of this one? So before this, what is there? Nothing means epsilon. So the first symbol is epsilon. So the next symbol is 0. So next symbol is 0. Next symbol is 0, 1. So next symbol is 01. Next symbol is 011. So we will have 011. Now let us go through suffix. Suffix means we will start from the end. Okay. So 011. So what we will have here also, we may assume that there is an epsilon. So epsilon, epsilon. Next, what is the symbol? 1. So 1. Next, what is the set of symbols? 11. So 11. Next, what is the set of symbols? 011. So 011. So next, go through substring. So substring, U is a substring of V. If V equal to, U will present over here, and on the left side you will have a string W, sorry, X, and you will have a string Y on the right hand side, where XY may also be again epsilon. It may be some string, it may be epsilon. So what is the substrings of 011? So here you can see that epsilon may be present, so epsilon. So from the start, if you are thinking, then you will have 0, 0. From the end, if you are thinking, you will have 1, so you will have 1. From the start, if you are thinking, you will have 0, 1, 0, 1. On the left hand side, you have epsilon. On the right hand side, you have 1. So similarly, you can have 1, 1. On the left hand side, you will have 0. On the right hand side, you will have epsilon. Similarly, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. On the left hand side, you will have epsilon. On the right hand side, you will have epsilon. So this is X, this is Y. So I hope all of you have understood the difference between prefix, suffix, and substring. So here you can see one interesting thing, that the original string, that is 0, 1, 1, is present in prefix, is present in suffix, is present also in substring. So note that if X is a prefix, or it may be suffix or substring to X, for any string X, this is one. And again, one thing you may notice, that epsilon is also prefix, suffix, and substring of any string. So I hope all of you have understood this one. So the note is what? The same string as well as epsilon are the part of prefix, suffix, and substring of all the strings. Next, power of a string. For any string X. Yes?
Sir, I'm unable to understand the suffix and prefix.
Okay, suffix and prefix we are unable to understand. So here you see, so 0, 1, 1. So let us go through prefix. Okay, U is a prefix of V. So U is a prefix of V. If we will write V equal to UX, so UX means that U is a string. String means it may be a zero length string epsilon, or it may contain one or more symbol. Okay, so here you see, if I will write this one as U, and after that I will use epsilon. So you see V equal to UX. So U is 011, X is epsilon. So if you will concat U and X, what you will get? 011, because epsilon means nothing, zero length string. So here X is a prefix. So you see X is what? Epsilon is a prefix. Now V equal to 011. So now here you see, so here we have to write UX. Okay, so here if I will consider this one as, sorry, if I will consider this one, it's U is a prefix, sorry. So here 011 is a prefix. Now let us go through another one. So let me consider this one as U and this one as X. So if I will concat UX, then what I will get? 011, right? So here U is a prefix. So here you see, if U is a prefix of V, if V equal to UX, where X is a string. So here X is a string, U is 0. So that's why 0 comes in prefix. Similarly, if I will take V equal to 011, if I will consider this one as U and this one as X, then you see 01 is a prefix. Similarly, if I will consider V equal to 011, I will consider this one as U and epsilon as X, then U is a prefix, means 011 is a prefix. So if you want to do it simply without going so deep into mathematically, so here you can see that prefix is nothing but, if I will take 011, you start from here. Pre means you know prepaid. Okay, so here you start from here. So before that, which symbol may appear? Epsilon. So epsilon is a prefix. Before that, which symbol may appear? 0. So 0. Before that, which symbol may appear? 01. So 01. Before that, which symbol may appear? 011. So these four are the prefix of the string 011. Similarly, here you see, which is this one. So suffix. Suffix is nothing but post. Okay, or you can say that postpaid, similar to postpaid. So here you see suffix of, if you want to find 011, so you start from the end. Okay, so here what is, if nothing, zero length string means epsilon, so epsilon is present. Next, you consider a single symbol, so one is the suffix. Now you consider two symbols, so 11 is the suffix. Now you consider three symbols, that is 011 is the suffix. I hope now you are clear regarding prefix and suffix.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. So next we will go through powers of a string. So for any string x, integer n greater than 0, if we use x to the power n, so power of a string means if there is a string x. So if you want to represent its power, so how we will denote it? We will denote it as x to the power n. So let me take an example. If there is a string x equal to 01, if I want to find x to the power 0, x to the power 0 means zero length string of x. So zero length string is epsilon, means there is no symbol. X to the power 1 means one length string, so it is 01. X to the power 2, x to the power 2 is nothing but x dot x. So x dot x is nothing but 01 followed by 01. X to the power 3 is nothing but x concatenation x square. So x is nothing but 01, x square is nothing but 0101. So I hope all of you have understood power. So x to the power n equal to epsilon, x to the power n equal to epsilon if n equal to 0. So now here you see, here n equal to 0. So what is the power of 0th power of that string? Epsilon. Otherwise, x to the power n is nothing but x into x to the power n minus 1. So here you see, x cube is equal to x into x to the power n minus 1, that is x to the power 3 minus 1, that is x to the power 2. So if I will find x 5, it is nothing but x into x to the power 4. So this is called as power of string. So I hope all of you have understood. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Next, power of alphabets. So similar to power of string, in string we are considering a set of symbols as a single word or a single string, whereas alphabet is a finite non-empty set of symbols. So here, if I will take the alphabet as for binary language, if I will take 0, 1. So if I will find x to the power 0 is nothing but 0 to the power 0 union 1 to the power 0. So it is nothing but, or here I can put a comma. So 0 to the power 0 is nothing but epsilon, comma epsilon, you will get epsilon. So 0th power is epsilon. So here it's not E, it's epsilon. So similarly, input alphabet to the power 1 means it contains all the strings with length 1. So this one, 0 and 1. And input alphabet to the power 2 is nothing but it contains all the strings of length 2, that is 00, 01, 10, 11. Similarly, input alphabet to the power 3 is nothing but it contains all the strings of length 3, so 002, 111. So I hope all of you have understood the powers of alphabet. If you are having any doubt, you can ask. Okay. Let us go to the next one. So the set of all strings over an input alphabet is denoted by input alphabet star. Okay. So input alphabet star is nothing but input alphabet to the power 0, input alpha union input alphabet to the power 1, union input alphabet to the power 2, union dot 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 input alphabet to the power n, or input alphabet to the power k. So it is nothing but union of input alphabet to the power, where k is greater than equal to 0. So next, reversal. So for any string w equal to, suppose we are having a string a1 a2 dot 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 an, the reversal of the string is denoted by w to the power r. Okay, w not to the power r, w superscript r. So it is nothing but the reversal of this string, that is an minus 1 dot 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 a1. So for example, if I will take w equal to 0, 1, 1, so the reversal of w equal to 1, 1, 0. So I hope all of you have understood this. Next, language. So what is a language? A language over an alphabet is a set of strings over that alphabet. So a symbol is the entity which cannot be defined, whereas alphabet is a finite set of symbols, non-empty finite set of symbols. Word is a non-empty finite concatenation of symbols, whereas language is a what? Non-empty finite set of strings over that input alphabet. So F is an empty language, so it means a language which contains no string, not even epsilon. Okay. So input alphabet star, so this one I have already told you, this is called as clean star operation, K-L-E-E-N star. So we will go through this one. So clean star operation is a language for any input alphabet. Epsilon is also a language for any input alphabet. Note that epsilon is not equal to 5. This is epsilon, okay? Epsilon is not equal to 5. What is epsilon? Epsilon is 0 length string, whereas what is phi? Phi is, phi means empty, nothing. Okay, zero length string means it is a string whose length is zero, means there is a string whose length is zero. Okay, but phi is nothing, it's not even zero length string. So F doesn't contain anything, any string, but epsilon contains one string of length 0. So please be careful regarding this. Epsilon means zero length string, but phi is nothing, not even zero length string. So the set of all strings over 0, 1, this is also maybe a language. the set of all strings over ABC, this which starts with A, this might be a language. Or here, let me give another example. The set of binary strings starting with zero is also a language because it consists of a set of strings. So what is language? Language over an alphabet is a set of strings. Okay, so now let us go through some of the operations of language. But before that, let me tell you the conventions of, so let me erase it first. Okay, so let me go through the convention. So here you see capital letters A, B, C, L. The capital letters A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. So these with or without subscript. So here you can write L1, L2. Like this also you can write. You may use subscript or you may not use subscript. Are normally used for denoting the languages. So you see we have notations. So for denoting language, we will use capital letter A, B, C, D. For denoting strings, we will use lowercase letters towards the end of English alphabet. For denoting symbols, we will use the lowercase alphabets from the beginning of English language. Okay, so these are the three conventions used for three different things. I hope all of you are clear. Next, operation of language. So set operation. Set operation means union. I hope all of you know union. So if there are two languages, let's say this is a language L1, this is a language L2. So what is the union of this one? So union of two languages is the non-repeatable symbols of both the languages. So 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, so 1, 0, 1, so you have already, so you see no need to repeat it, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0. So intersection similarly you know that. So if a language L1 is here, L2 is this one. So L1 intersection L2 is an element X, which is an element of L1 as well as that is an element of L2. So this is L1, this is L2. Okay. So what is common between them means which element is present in both the sets. So that is 0, 1. So the L1 intersection L2 is 0, 1. Next, complement. So this one I need to tell you. So usually input alphabet star, okay, is the universe that a complement is taken with respect to. Thus the language, so you see input alphabet star means what? It is nothing but this is equal to input alphabet power 0 union input alphabet power 1 union input alphabet power 2 dot 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 input alphabet power n. So this is the set of all possible strings that a language may have. So this is the universe for the, or this is the universal set for a language. Thus for a language L, the complement is denoted by L bar. So x is an element of L star, where x doesn't belong to L. X is not an element of L. So example, if L equal to x, so element such that mod x means length of x is even. If this is L, what is L bar? L bar is nothing but x which belongs to x star, such that length of x is not even. Not even means it is odd. So if L is this one, this is L bar, or that is called its complement of L. So I hope all of you have understood the set operations, that is union, intersection and complement. Next, reversal of language. So reversal of language is similar to reversal of string. So reversal of a language means reversal of all the strings present in that language. So here you see, let us take an example L. So L is a language, I have already told you capital letters are used to denote languages. Okay. So language is a set of words. So this is a word, this is a word, this is a word, this is a word. So LR means reversal of L is nothing but reversal of all the strings present in that language. So 0's reversal is 0, 11's reversal is 11, 01's reversal is 10, 011's reversal is 110. So this is the reversal of language. Next, language concatenation. So the concatenation of two languages L1, L2 is defined by L1, L2. So this is also same to concatenation of strings or concatenation of words. So it is what? It is the concatenation of all the symbols, all pairwise symbols. So here you see, so this is a language, let's say L1. This is a language, let's say L2. Now if I want to combine or sorry, concatenate L1, L2, then it is denoted by L1, L2. So how it will be done? So the first symbol will be concatenated with the first symbol, which will result in a string. Next, the first symbol will be concatenated with the second symbol, which will be resulted in the second string, A, B, A. Next, the second symbol, sorry, second string will be concatenated with the first string, that will result in another string. Next, the second string will be concatenated with the second string of the second language, that will result in another string. So I hope all of you have understood the language concatenation. This is a pairwise concatenation of words of languages. So note that, so it is very, very important. So let me erase all the things. Okay, so L1 into L1 concatenation L2 is not necessarily, so in general, it's not equal to L1 concatenation L2. So here you see, if I will write L1 equal to 0, 1, if I will write L2 equal to AB. So now you see, so L1, L2. So what I will get? 0A, 0B, 1A, 1B. So this is set operation, okay? So L2, L1 equal to, what you will get? A0, A1, B0, B1. So you see L1, L2 is not equal to L2, L1. But it's not always, okay? In general, this is not equal to. But if both the symbols are same in both the languages, then it will be equal. Next, the important thing is L concatenated with 5 is 5. L concatenated with epsilon is L, okay? So this is not the case. Or which contains epsilon, okay? So L of epsilon is epsilon, L concatenation pi is pi. So I will repeat again, L concatenation with pi is pi, L language of epsilon is nothing but the same language which contains epsilon. Which contains epsilon. Next, iterated concatenation of languages. So now we have learned concatenation. Now iterated concatenation means we will repeatedly concat. So here you see L0 is epsilon. L0 means L to the power 0. It's not here, it should be here. Okay. L to the power 0, it will contain epsilon. Okay. It's not E, it's epsilon. Okay. So L to the power N, this is similar to power of alphabet. Okay. L to the power n is L concatenation L to the power n minus 1. So now let us go through an example. Let's L equal to AB, A comma AB. So there are two strings in the language. So if we will find L0, so I think it's not at the top, it should be at the bottom. Okay. So L concatenation, because here I have written the symbols like this. I have taken it from website. Okay. So L0. L concatenated 0 times, so it contains epsilon. So L contains 1 time. So what it will give you? It will give you L, that is A B. L2 is nothing but L concatenated with L. So A A A A B A B A B A A B A B A B A B. So now L3, or if you will go through, if you will consider it as power, so what it will be? L into L2 or L power 2. So L is this one, L power 2 is this one. So now if you will concatenate A AA, so you will get 3S. AAA, so 3AB. Similarly, you will get this string. So I hope all of you have understood iterated concatenation of language. That is repeated concatenation of language. So next one is nils star operation. So this one I have already told you. So this is L star. Okay, is nothing but language to the power 0, union language to the power 1, union language to the power 2. So I am sorry that I haven't remained consistent. So it should be 1 at the top, it should be 1 at the top, it should be 0, it should be 1, it should be 2, it should be 3. Okay, similarly everything over here will change. So union, so nils star operation over the on a language L is denoted by L star, is defined as follows: L0 union L1 union L2 union everything. So X is the concatenation of zero or more strings from L. So here there is one more important thing: L plus. So L plus means all strings derivable by one or more concatenation. So your zero concatenation or epsilon will eliminate. So here you see, if I will write zero star means what? All combination, all length strings means zero length string is epsilon, one length string is zero, two length string is zero zero, three length string is zero zero zero, dot dot dot, it will continue. But if I will write zero plus is nothing but, so here you see plus, L plus is nothing but L into L star. So L is nothing but, it contains 0 into 0 L star. L star means epsilon 0 0 0 0 0 0 dot dot dot. So if you will concatenate these two, so 0 concatenated with epsilon, it will give you 0. 0 concatenated with 0, it will give you 0 0. 0 concatenated with 0 0, it will give you 0 0 0. So you see, it will give you all the strings excluding the zero length string. So this is the difference between L star and L plus. You see, L star you have zero length strings, but in L plus you will start from one length string. So I hope all of you have understood this.